Hi friends, in this video let us discuss speed time curve. So as the name indicates, it's the curve between speed and time. So let me first draw it. So speed is taken on y axis. Speed. And time is taken on x-axis. This is the time. On y-axis, speed is taken, and this is the time. So with this we need to draw something extra, and that is called, we need to see the tractive effort and also gross tractive effort and the train resistance also. They can be drawn here. So first let us finish speed time curve. The first important thing in speed time curve is, in speed time curve the speed is on y-axis and time is on x-axis. So here we can see the area of the curve. So area of the curve will give us, maybe if it is a rectangle, x into y, or we can say speed v into time t, and that can be treated as speed. Speed means it is distance divided by time into time may give us distance. That means if you take the area of this curve from one point to other point, you will get the distance in that, in those two points, distance covered in those two points. Similarly, if you see the slope of it, slope means it is y divided by x. That means y means it is speed, divided by x is the time. So speed by time is the acceleration. So this may be acceleration or retardation. So the slope of this curve at any point can give us either acceleration or retardation, and the area under the curve give us distance. So this is the explanation for speed time curve. If the speed is taken on y-axis and time is taken on x-axis, we can get the area, we can get the distance by taking the area under the curve, and we can get the acceleration by taking the slope of the point. First, let us see how it starts. First, the first point is, it is a straight line. Up to some point it is a straight line, so the speed is constantly increasing with respect to the time. So we can call, we can take this as constant acceleration period. So up to this point the acceleration is constant, and so this period is called notching up period, because this is the starting point of the train. This train starts by cutting off the notches. That means we are keep on reducing the resistance for the motor. That means the motor is connected to the supply in through a resistance, and that resistance will be cutting off in this notching up period. In that case, I need to draw the tractive, total tractive effort here. This is the tractive effort. So what exactly happens if the resistances keep on cutting slowly from standstill? That means, so if the train is ready to start, we need to keep on cutting the resistance. If we are keep on cutting the resistance, the current is limited but the current is always fluctuating in two points. One is minimum point and maximum point. As we know, the current depends here, the tractive effort F depends on torque exerted by the motor, and this torque depends on the current given to the motor. So as the current is varying between two points, minimum and maximum point, torque is varying and also tractive effort is varying. So this is the thing. So as the tractive effort is varying from in between two points, this is the representation of total tractive effort. Here tractive effort means this is the force exerted by the driving wheel on rails, and that force is so with speed time curve I need to take total tractive effort. Tractive effort means this is the force exerted by the driving wheel on the rails or track. So that effort, that force is called tractive effort. And if the tractive effort means that is the given by one driving wheel, if this is, that is the sum of all driving wheels, forces exerted by sum of all driving wheels, that is called gross tractive effort. So here I need to see, take the gross tractive effort here. The gross tractive effort is dependent on the torque exerted by the motor, and the torque exerted by the motor is dependent on the current flowing through the motor. As in notching up period, we are keep on cutting the resistances, the current is limited between two points, minimum and maximum points. So the current is varying between two points, so the torque is also varying between two points, so the gross tractive effort is varying between two points. And here is the representation for gross tractive effort, and we are keep on increasing the acceleration here keep on increasing the speed. So here the acceleration is constant from this point to this point, so we are keep on increasing the speed, keeping the acceleration constant. So this period is called notching up period. And there is second period called acceleration period. In this period, this is a curve like this. So it is, in this period the acceleration is somewhat reduced, and this, for this the total tractive effort will be reducing like this up to this point, and at this point the train resistance is equal to the tractive effort. And here I will draw train resistance, and this is the train resistance. Train resistance is varying like this, and these two, I will write these two curves. Actually the total curve is from here to up to this point, this is called gross tractive effort. And this point is train resistance. So after notching up period, the total resistance was cut out, and suddenly the speed is increasing, but the tractive effort is reducing, because we now need to produce that much tractive effort as all resistances are cut out. So the tractive effort is reducing. And once this point is increasing up to certain point, and that after that it will become constant, and that at that point where the train resistance is equal to the gross tractive effort, that means after that point there is no increment in the speed, and that is the maximum limit for the increment in speed. So after this there is the speed becomes constant up to certain point, and this point, this period is called free running period. And after this, there is a coasting period. That means after this point, we are cutting off the supply. Yes, supply has been cut off. So this is called coasting period. As supply has been cut off, the train is running with its own momentum and there is no supply to the motors. So there is no torque and there is no tractive effort. But still, it has its own momentum. So it is declining. The speed is declining, but still there is some speed. And after this point, if I keep on living like that, this will come and reach the train will stop at this time, but I want to make the train stop beforehand, so I will definitely apply some brake here, and at this point I have applied the brakes. So this completes the track speed time curve. And let us keenly observe the things here. So up to this point, this is time t1, and up to this point, this is time t2, and up to this point, this is time t3, and up to this point, it is time t4. Yes, so the first one is called notching up period. This is 0, so 0 to T1 is called notching up period. 0 to T1, this is called notching up period. Notching up period. And T1 to T2 is called acceleration period. And T2 to T3 is called free running period, where it is running with the constant speed. And T3 to T4 is called coasting period. Coasting period. And T4 to T5 is called, it is braking period. So these are the different parts of speed time curve. So we can one more time we can see what exactly happens in these things. From 0 to T1, it is notching up period. So the resistance is slowly cutting off. And once it has been cut completely, the tractive effort is reduced. So the speed is gradually reaching the maximum value, but the acceleration is reduced when compared to the previous notching up period. So this period is called acceleration period. From T2 to T3, the speed is constant, so this is called free running period. From T3 to T4, this is called coasting period. So at T3, the supply given to the motor is cut off, so it is declining the speed. And if you leave like that, it will reach zero speed at this point, but we are applying brakes at T4, so it is reaching the zero point at T5. Okay, this is the clear thing. So let us see what are the different angles over here. So different angles here are, this angle is tan inverse alpha, where alpha is the acceleration at this period, and this is called tan inverse beta, where beta is the retardation, and this is called tan inverse beta c, where beta c is called coasting retardation. And these are the different angles we have considered. As we already discussed, the slope at any point gives us the acceleration, and here in this triangle the slope is alpha, so the angle becomes tan inverse alpha. Similarly here, slope is beta, and in this triangle it is beta c. So this is the complete explanation of speed time curve. So please see it. If you have any doubts, please mail me or you can post it in the comment box. And please like this video. And if you still have any doubts, you can always free to ask any doubts in the comment section. And please share with your friends and colleagues. And please, if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do subscribe. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.